really has nothing to do with horses or investing, but it's kind of goofy and I hope you enjoy it. There we go. Esther the esteemed equestrian had a reputation for investing in equities imbued with equilibrium and commodities like gold and aluminium. Watching the markets with a nervous eye, Esther thought at times she should diversify. She asked for friends' advice with a pleading sigh, hoping they would recommend what next to buy. Esther had a college friend whose name was Marge. She looked her up and found that she was still at large. Marge had made some big bucks through arbitrage, explaining the Ferrari in her garage. Munson built his wealth with bonds municipal and was eager to advise on things logistical. Esther felt the feeling was reciprocal. She had interest in a man who kept his principle. Ivan, with inevitable bravado, advocated advertising avocados. Invest in veggies, that was his motto, 'cause he'd made $1 million in tomatoes. Banker Barry, who looked like a beagle, said always be upfront and keep it legal. Strive to soar high like an eagle, adhere to laws like Dodd-Frank and Glass-Steagall. Thank you, both of you bankers, for getting that. Fleeing the fine points of high finance, Esther concluded she would take a chance by investing her parents' inheritance in horses that can race and run and trot and prance. Now the purchase of an equine mammalian involves extensive research and maybe an excursion to rodeos Canadian, but she settled on a thoroughbred Arabian. Esther, in her effort to be truer, became an eager equine entrepreneur. Embraced things organicer and purer, and profited from selling horse manure. Patty, the purveyor of oleo, pestered Esther to expand her portfolio, provoking passion to the point of an imbroglio, till the two of them faced off toe-to-toleo. Exasperated by her friend's suggestion, Esther asked the inevitable question, with fears evoking tears and congestion, is it worth insomnia and indigestion? Injured by the spirit acrimonious, she no longer felt investing was harmonious. For the last discussion proved so parsimonious, perhaps Esther's expectations were erroneous. So Esther, the esteemed equestrian, divested business lines she had invested in, declaring now she so thoroughly detested them, and bought a fixed annuity like the rest of them. Thank you.